Stanley had never seen the office this brightly lit. Was it a sign of something? He hoped it was. He hoped very much that it was. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. Okay, I think we all know the drill by now. Blah, blah, blah. Dark secrets, the keypad. Stanley pushes some buttons. Oh, hey, look, it's a new passageway. Kill surprise. Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. Although this passageway had the word Escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent. The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his. As the machine whirred into motion and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his was of no great loss. And so he resigned and willingly accepted this to his brief and shallow life. Farewell, Stanley.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish? When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, becomes meaningless, making the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already from the moment he hit start?
And finally, he pushed the number 9. Stanley pushed the orange lever. Now look closely, Stanley. See how it's impossible for the player to do anything in this room? Perfect example of poor level design. Textbook mistake. It's the kind of thing you'd pick up on intuitively if you had even the most fundamental understanding of the good and bad design. But of course, you being you, they're throwing us in the next hour trying to solve for all his button pushing. I'm just going to make this easy on you. sure we'll get him right back on track to where he's supposed to be.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to away one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free. Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now and it'll be your only true choice. Whatever you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let... Thank you.